this video on polynomials. In this session, we will learn about division of polynomials and remainder theorem. Friends, you might be familiar with the term remainder. Do you remember where you have heard it? Generally, when we divide a number with another number, we get a remainder, which at times can be zero. For example, if we divide 8 by 4, we get the remainder as 0. Whereas, if 10 is divided by 4, the remainder is 2. We can also represent this process as 8 is equal to 4 multiplied by 2 plus 0 and 10 is equal to 4 multiplied by 2 plus 2. And we can say dividend is equal to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder. It is important to note that when a number divides the other number completely, then it is called the factor of that number. Here, 4 is the factor of 8. We can do something similar with polynomials also. Let's first see how a given polynomial can be divided by a linear polynomial. Let's start. Find the remainder obtained by dividing the polynomial 3x squared minus 7 minus 5x by x plus 1. Our first step is to arrange the terms in the polynomial in descending order of their power or degree. That is, starting from the term with highest power to the constant term. Now let us solve using the division method. In the second step, we will focus only on the first terms of both dividend and divisor. Here, the first term of the dividend is 3x squared and the first term of the divisor is x. Now, if we divide 3x squared by x, we will get 3x. This is what we have to keep in mind each time. Now, place 3x in the quotient and multiply 3x by all the terms of the divisor. Now, we get plus 3x squared plus 3x, which we will write here and subtract just like we do with numbers. When we subtract, the signs of the terms change. Here, we will get minus 8x. Bring the remaining terms of the dividend down just like we do for numbers. Friends, can you tell what will be our next step? We will now focus on x and minus 8x. Friends, sometimes we don't pay attention to signs. Do not forget to pay attention to signs. Now let's see what we will get when we divide minus 8x by x. The number that we get is minus 8. Let's write minus 8 in the quotient place, and if we multiply it with all the terms of the divisor, we get minus 8x minus 8. When we subtract it, we are left with remainder 1. We can represent this division in the form of 3x squared minus 5x minus 7 is equal to x plus 1, 3x minus 8 plus 1. Friends, the division process will not be complete till we get the power of the remainder 1 less than that of the divisor. This means, if the divisor is a linear polynomial, then the remainder should be a constant polynomial or any number or zero. Now let's find P of minus 1 for the polynomial P of x is equal to 3x squared minus 5x minus 7. We got 1 as the remainder, which is the same as what we got by the division method. And where did we get this minus 1 that we substituted in the polynomial? We got that from the divisor. And this is the remainder theorem. So friends, let's assume P of x is a polynomial with degree greater than or equal to 1 and a is a real number. If the polynomial P of x is divided by a linear polynomial x minus a, the remainder we get is P of a. Now let's compare this with our previous example where we divided the polynomial 3x squared minus 5x minus 7 by a linear polynomial x minus minus 1 and we got the remainder P of minus 1 is equal to 1. And if the remainder is found to be 0, then P of A is equal to 0. And in such situations, A is the 0 of the polynomial. Let's look at an example for this. On dividing the polynomial x square minus 3x plus 2 by x minus 2, we get the remainder as 0. Now, by equating the divisor x minus 2 to 0, we get x is equal to 2 and P of 2 will be 0. That means 2 is the 0 of this polynomial. So friends, with this, let's end this video. In this session, we learned about division of polynomials and the remainder theorem. See you in the next video, where we will solve some questions based on this topic.